Assalamualaikum. Alright, tajuk seterusnya adalah business plan. Okay, business plan development. Kenapa kita nak buat business plan? Ingat tak tadi dah ada stage-stage dia kan? Step yang kedua, korang kena buat ideation dan juga business plan. So, dalam business plan ni, kita akan ajar you, teach the student how to create a comprehensive business plan that covers all aspect of the new enterprise, including market analysis, financial projection and operational detail. Dalam business plan ni, you kena create a comprehensive business plan, which is you boleh, you kena conduct lah sebelum you nak buat comprehensive business plan tu, you kena conduct all the benda-benda yang related lah, especially masa you kena conduct a market analysis, you kena develop financial projection and also define the operational details. So what is a business plan? Normally, business plan ni adalah a written narrative, typically 25 to 35 pages long, that describe what a new business plan to accomplish. It is actually the planning. The planning dalam bentuk written lah. So, business plan yang biasa buat dalam 25 to 35 pages sahaja. Dan dekat situ, you boleh ceritakan apakah planning you yang you akan buat untuk you punya new enterprise. For most new venture, the business plan is a dual purpose document used both inside and outside the firm. Normally, business plan ni kita akan guna di peringkat dalaman dalam syarikat ataupun untuk kegunaan luaran juga. Okay, so it is a dual use document. Dual purpose lah. Sebab apa? Siapa yang akan read the business plan? Yang pertama adalah, macam saya cakap tadi, dua orang dalaman dan luaran. Untuk dalaman, siapa yang akan baca the business plan? They are two primary audience lah. Okay, yang pertama adalah firm employees. Kita punya pekerja. A clearly written business plan will help the employees of a firm operate in synchronized and move forward in a consistent and purposely manner. Kalau ahli-ahli dalam syarikat tu, pekerja lah kita kata ya, tahu apa yang you nak capai dalam masa setahun, dalam masa tiga tahun, dalam masa lima tahun, dalam masa sepuluh tahun. Apa yang korang nak bagi, what are value proposition yang korang nak bagi dekat customer. Apa yang you ada, SOP yang you ada. Apa you punya resources yang you ada. Berapa financial plan you, apa operation you. Bila ahli ataupun kita kata pekerja you jelas dengan apa yang korang nak tadi, so mereka akan bekerja dengan smoothly. Okay, smoothly dan synchronize. Okay, selain daripada itu, orang yang akan baca business plan ni juga adalah investor ataupun other external stakeholders. Kadang-kadang bila kita nak berbisnes, kita memerlukan suntikan dana ataupun funding daripada luar. Jadi orang nak tahu, you nak present, kadang-kadang bila you present verbally, orang tak nampak sangat. So you have to write a business plan so that business plan tu boleh diberi kepada investor untuk dibaca. So a firm business plan must make the case that the firm is good use of an investor fund or the attention of others. Selain daripada tu, you boleh pitching dan sebagainya lah. Especially untuk fund lah ya. Guideline of writing for business plan. Structure of the business plan. To make the best impression of business plan, should follow a conventional structure. Business plan ni satu dunia pakai. You tak payah nak memandai-mandai, nak buat benda lain. Okay, the outline of the business plan yang kita akan bincangkan untuk next ni adalah benda yang digunapakai oleh satu dunia. Okay, although some entrepreneur want to demonstrate creativity, departing from the basic structure for the conventional business plan is usually a mistake. Kalau you nak memandai-mandai, tak nak masukkan apa yang ada sepatutnya dalam business plan ni, kadang-kadang benda tu adalah satu kesilapan besar. Sebab apa? Investor ni dia busy people dan dia nak a plan where they can easily find critical information. Kita nak tahu critical information sahaja yang perlu ada dalam you punya business plan. So, jadi korang pun jangan buat banyak ya. Jangan buat banyak. So basically, business plan ni ramai dah orang buat. Custom dekat market, you boleh Google sahaja. Dah ada dah. Dah ada dalam bentuk software dan sebagainya. So there are many software package available that employ item. Korang kalau korang dah belajar bagaimana writing business plan ni, korang boleh buat business. Ramai usahawan kat luar tu mencari-cari business plan. So korang buat siap-siap, korang boleh jual template. Okay, template. So there are many software package available that employ an interactive menu-driven approach to assist in the writing of a business plan. Some of these program are very helpful. However, entrepreneurs should avoid a boilerplate plan that looks as stuff it come from a canned source. Tapi kena ML lah, ikut you punya resources and you punya team. So walaupun dah ada template dekat luar tu disediakan, tapi you kena ML juga.
Okay.
Dalam business plan tu juga dia akan menunjukkan sense of excitement. Sebab you ada fact and figure, business plan needs to project a sense of anticipation and excitement about the possibility that surround a new venture. Sebab tu bila kita buat business plan tu, kita kena duduk dengan usahawan tu. So kalau you adalah usahawan, maksud you sendirilah you kena duduk tengok business plan you. Sebab orang tak tahu apa yang ada dalam kepala you. Sebabnya, dan bila kita siap business plan tu, ia akan menunjukkan anticipation dan excitement. Kat mana kita nak mula, kat mana yang kita patut reduce, kat mana yang kita patut invest. So kat situ semua adalah. Content of the business plan, dia akan give a clear and concise information on all the important aspect of the proposed venture. It must be long enough to provide sufficient information, yet short enough to maintain reader interest. Kita kena make sure all the information yang kita nak bagi tu dah ada, tapi dalam bentuk yang tidak memboringkan pembaca. Okay, so sebab tu normally business plan dalam 25 ke 35 pages sahaja. Okay, so ada beberapa jenis business plan sebenarnya. Okay, ada 3 contoh business plan. Antaranya adalah 10 hingga 15 pages, 25 hingga 35 pages, 40 hingga 100 pages. Satu page pun ada. Satu page tu kita panggil business model canvas lah. So business plan 10 hingga 15 ni summary. Summary ni biasanya kita bagi bila kita nak pitching. Kalau kamu macam dia panggil untuk pitching, nak dapatkan funding, buat 10 hingga 15 pages cukup. Sebab orang macam orang-orang yang panel-panel pitching tu dia orang yang busy. So dia tak sempat nak baca 25 hingga 35 pages tu. So work best summary business plan ni adalah work best for a new venture in the early stage of development that want to test the water to see if investor are interested in the idea. Okay, normally korang pun patut buat 10 hingga 15 tapi takut tak lengkap, korang buatlah full business plan. 25 hingga 35 pages. Work best for a new venture who are at the point where they need funding or financing, serve as a blueprint for the company's operation. So cuba buat antara 25 hingga 35 pages. Next adalah operational business plan. It's mean primarily for an internal audience. Work best as a tool for creating a blueprint for new ventures operation and providing guidance to operational manager. Biasanya ini adalah hala tuju lah. Operational business plan. 40 to 100 pages. Alright. Okay, guidelines for writing a business plan. Kita kena ada beberapa perkara lah yang kita tengok untuk kita immerse dalam writing our business plan. Okay, outline of the business plan. Yang pertama adalah executive summary. Yang pertama adalah apa? Executive summary. Executive summary is a short overview of the entire business plan. It provides a busy reader with everything that needs to be known about the new venture's distinctive nature. And executive summary should not exceed 2 single space pages. So you kena buatlah sama ada single page ataupun 2 single space pages. Okay, 1 page ataupun 2 pages lah korang kena buat. So dalam executive summary ni, apa yang korang kena buat adalah entire plan. Okay, a copy of the entire plan. Apa tu? Yang convincing lah. Yang convincing. You ambil yang ni je. Yang apa orang kata, surface sahaja. Okay. Yang kedua, section kedua adalah industry analysis. Industry analysis adalah begin by describing the industry, the business we enter in term of size, growth, rate and sale projection. Normally kita nak tengok industri tu, contoh kalau Contoh saya buat kopi kan. So saya buat kedai kafe, saya kena faham industri analisis saya. Maksudnya saya kena faham size yang saya boleh cater, growth rate yang saya boleh, yang insyaAllah saya dapat buat, and sale projection. Industry structure. Contoh kalau you buat travel agency, you kena faham apa fungsi motek, apa fungsi persatuan-persatuan, kat mana korang kena daftar. So you, all the things yang ada dalam industri tu you kena faham lah. Industry structure, nature of participant. Participant ni maksudnya pekerja you, you punya customer, you punya competitor. Okay, nature of participant, key success factor, apa yang menyebabkan satu-satu company tu sukses. Kena tahu, kena faham siap-siap, kena buat research. Industry trend and also long term perspective. Before a business select a target market, it should have a good grasp of its industry, ya, including where its promising area and where its point of vulnerability are. Okay, so ni, this is the thing yang you kena include dalam you punya report nanti. Okay, next adalah company description. It's all about your company. Your company description, ceritalah nama company, siapa buat, lepas tu meniaga apa, ya. Company history, mission statement, mesti ada mission statement. Mission statement tu semua ni kena buat, eh. Kita akan cuba buat dalam tutorial ke macam mana. Mission statement, eh. Saya rasa benda ni dah belajar sebenarnya dalam ni. Okay, dalam asas. Product and service, mission statement tu adalah objektif yang korang nak pakai, nak capai dalam waktu terdekat. Okay, kena ada produk dan servis. Kenalkan juga produk dan servis dengan harga dan sebagainya. Current status, contoh ada berapa orang dalam tu, ya. Legal status, NOC, ni yang ada SSM, SSU. Korang kena pre-screen tu SSU korang tu masuk dalam korang punya ni. And then key partnership lah kalau ada. Okay, and then section keempat, market analysis. The market analysis break the industry into segment and zero in the specific segment. Okay, contoh yang ada patut ada dalam market analysis ni. Okay, dia macam ni. Market analysis tu, most startup do not service their entire industry. Instead, they focus on servicing a specific ataupun target market within the industry. You kena target tu kan? Sebab tu kita buat customer segment tu. It's important to include a section in the market analysis that deal with the behavior of the consumer in the market. The more a startup knows about the consumer in its target market, the more it can tailor its product and service appropriately. So, item that can include in this section adalah market segmentation and market and target market selection. Siapa market segmentation kamu? Okay, kalau kamu kata wanita, okay, wanita umur berapa? Kalau kamu kata baby, baby umur berapa? Kalau kamu kata usahawan. Usahawan pula dah. Ahli sukan. Ahli sukan umur berapa? Faham? Lepas tu, tengok market segmentation and target ni. And then buyer behavior. Duduk, market segmentation tu dia termasuk yang okay, duduk kat mana, kerja apa, umur berapa, tu kena masukkan, eh. Buyer behavior, contoh kalau wanita, you nak cari mana. Kalau produk you tu harga mahal, so mestilah behavior yang datin-datin. Faham tak? Kalau katalah produk sukan, maksudnya orang sukan, macam tu. And then competitor analysis. Competitor analysis, you tengok competitor you, okay, yang sekeliling you tu apa yang diorang provide, services yang diorang provide, dan customer macam mana yang diorang tackle. Okay, yang kelima adalah economics of the business. Bila cerita economic, ia adalah something yang financial lah kan. So, two company in the same industry may make profit in different ways. One may be a high margin, low volume business, while the other may be a low margin, high volume business. It's important to check to make sure the approach you select is sound. Computing a break-even analysis is an extremely useful exercise for any proposed or existing business. Economic business, kena belajar. This section address the basic logic of how profit are earned in the business and how many units of a business profit must be sold for the business to break even. Bila awak nak start untung, berapa awak nak untung, semua ni kena kira, eh. Alright, so item to include in this section adalah revenue drivers and profit margin. kena kira fixed and variable cost, operating leverage and its implication, startup cost, break even chart and calculation. Section 6 adalah marketing plan. Marketing plan adalah the best way to describe the startup marketing plan is to start by articulating its marketing strategy, positioning and points of differentiation, and then talk about how this overall aspect of the plan will be supported by price, promotional mix and distribution strategy. It's also important to discuss the company's sales process. Macam mana you nak market and sales. So, marketing plan focus on how the business will market and sell. Sale, but the sales. Its product or service. Dia include, item to include in this section ialah overall marketing strategy. Boleh guna teknik 4P tu, product, price, promotion and distribution. Okay, you kena tunjukkan bagaimana you punya sales process or cycle of the sales process and also sales tactics. Okay, design and development plan. Many seemingly promising startup never get off the ground because their product development effort stall or the actual development of the product or service turn out to be more difficult than thought. As a result, this is a very important section for business developing a completely new product or service. Okay, so design and development ni ramai orang macam claim lah gitu gini, tapi sebenarnya dia tak faham pun apa yang dia patut conduct semasa design and development product tu. Okay, so design development plan, if you are developing a completely new product service, you need to include a section in your business plan that focus on the status of your development effort. Kalau, especially kalau business tu tak pernah orang buat ataupun business model you tu jarang orang buat, you kena buat design and development plan. Item to include in this section, ada development status and task. Kalau you buat product, you kena tulis lah menu semua-semua tu lah kan, macam mana you develop. Challenge and risk, projected development cost, priority issue, contohnya pattern, trademark, copyright, license and also brand name. Semua tu kena ada dalam you punya projection tadi. Section 8 adalah operation plan. Operation plan ni kita akan outline how your business will be run and how your product also will be produced. It is a useful way to illustrate how a business will be run is to describe in terms of backstage. Ayat dia backstage lah kalau operation plan ni. And front stage. So item yang patut ada dalam operation plan ni adalah general approach to operation, business location, facilities and equipment. Okay. Section 9 adalah management team and company structure. So the management team of a new venture typically consists of the founder or founders and a handful of key management personnel. So you kena masukkan management team, board of directors, board of advisor and also company structure. Many investor and others who read the business plan, dia akan look first at the executive summary and then go directly to the management team section. Kenapa? To assess the strength of the people starting the firm. Section 10 adalah overall schedule. A schedule should be prepared that shows the major event required to launch the business. The schedule should be in the format of milestone critical to the business success. Example of milestone, incorporating the venture, completion of prototype, rental of facilities, obtaining critical financing, starting production, obtaining the first scale. Yang ni kita kena ada macam, you kena buat, tahu tak, carta gun. So normally kita buat dalam bentuk carta gun lah, kita punya projection. And effective overall schedule ni is an effectively prepared and presented schedule lah. So you boleh buat, so that you boleh convince potential investor that the management team is aware of. Contoh macam you nak dapat apa awak punya income tu year 1, year 2, year 3, year 4, macam tu. Ataupun you punya plan, katakanlah buka coffee story dekat Kota Baru 1. Tahun kedua nak buka dekat KL 1. Tahun ketiga nak buka dekat 5 negeri lain, contoh. So you dah ada schedule dia. Financial projection sama, apa yang berlaku, the final section of business plan present a firm or performa, financial projection, ni projected lah ya, yang ada kat sini adalah sources and uses of fund statement, assumption sheet, pro forma income statement, pro forma balance sheet, pro forma cash flow and also ratio analysis. Yang ni kita akan belajar dalam financial. And then bila you dah siap, you kena present lah. Present business plan to investor. Yang ni yang kita akan buat business pitching, ya. Yeah? So, dia akan buat, kalau business pitching, itu adalah oral presentation lah ayat dia sama. Okay, so the first rule in making an oral presentation is to follow direction. You kena buat ikut tadi tu, step by step tu. So, kena ikut allocation masa, kalau 15 minit, 15 minit, tak boleh lebih. And then, mesti ada smooth and well rehearsed. Kena practice dulu sebelum you pergi pitching. The slide should be sharp and not cluttered. Eh? Bila you buat slide masa present tu, saya tak nak macam cacar merbang. Mesti ada orang yang in charge pasal slide. You ramai kan? You 10 orang. Cari orang yang boleh in charge pasal slide tu. Very sharp and not cluttered. Eh? Question and feedback to expect. Ni biasalah. Eh? You akan dapat. Bila you pitching ataupun you present, mesti akan dapat question and feedback from investor lah. So, you kena prepare of the normal question yang akan ditanya. So, masa you nak present, this is the point yang you kena include dah eh, masa dekat presentation tu. Jangan nak kreatif sangat. Kena ikut ni eh. Ini ada title slide, problem, solution, opportunity and target market, technology, competition, marketing and sales, management team, financial projection, current status, financing stock and also summary. Developing an effective business model. Okay, habis pasal business plan. Kat situ ada soalan ke tak ada? Ada soalan ke? You all, ada soalan ke? Okay. Confirm eh, tak ada? Okay, next adalah business model eh. What is business model? Selain daripada business plan, kita kena faham pasal business model. Model is a plan or diagram that used to make or describe something. Business model adalah its plan or diagram for how it competes. Uses its resources, structure its relationship, interface with a customer and creates value to sustain itself on the basis of the profit it generates. So, the term of business model is used to include all the activities that define how a firm compete in the marketplace. Normally, dia adalah satu diagram bagaimana korang conduct resources dia. Macam mana interface dengan customer, create value dan macam mana you create the profit. Okay, business model ni ada banyak lah. Ni contoh kita ambil Dell business model. Dell ni Dell lah, tahu tak Dell? Tahu tak Dell? Pernah dengar kat mana Dell ni? Pernah kenal Acer? You are pernah kenal Acer tak?
Pernah.
Apa dia Acer? Apa dia Acer?
Laptop.
Laptop. Ha, sama juga. Dell pun sama. Okay, Dell pun samalah ya. Okay, Dell business model ni, contoh Dell ni. Dell ni nama laptop, nama komputer lah kan? Nama brand. Dia buat apa? Normally, pada zaman dia ni, pada zaman Dell ni, orang akan, bila you buka kilang komputer, you ada brand sendiri. Okay? Brand sendiri. In that case, it needs the cooperation of its supply, customers and many others to make its business model work. Apa yang dia buat? Dia hanya ada store penyimpanan sahaja. Tapi dia tak buat. Maksudnya dia order dekat kilang, dia minta orang kilang tu letak nama dia Dell dan dia hanya jual bila ada order. Faham tak? So dijual bila ada order daripada kilang. Okay, order tu maknanya kilang lah, kilang yang ni. Maksudnya dia tak buat. Dia tidak apa orang panggil, dia tak assemble benda tu. Okay. Jadi dia tidak akan menanggung, dia tak perlu bayar tempat gudang, sewa gudang dan sebagainya lah. Jadi jimat kat situ. Dia hanya buat marketing je. Okay. The importance of business model, kenapa pentingnya business model kita ada? Sebab kita nak having a clearly articulated business model. Okay, sebab kita nak make sure we can serve as an ongoing extension of feasibility analysis. We can focus attention on how all the elements of a business fit together and constitute a working whole. We can describe why the network of participants needed to make a business idea viable are willing to work together and articulates a company's core logic to all stakeholders including the firm employee. Jadi dia pentinglah supaya macam business plan tadi. Kalau kita tak faham business model kita, maka contoh business model, kalau you nak buat retail, you tak boleh, you janganlah kalau you buat retail, you jangan apa? Bila you nak jual retail, contohlah macam you nak jual sendiri kan. Janganlah ambil agent atau stokis. Sebab bila you sendiri tu, you boleh main harga dan sebagainya. Tapi kalau you ada agent atau stokis, terpaksa mengikut perjanjian. Jadi, kita tengok business model kita. Ada business model yang macam ada barang tapi tak ada jenama. Ada orang yang ada jenama, tak ada barang. Bukan barang, maksudnya macam tak ada kilang ke. Ada orang dia memang ada barang dan ada kilang dan ada jenama. Jadi it depends eh. Okay, so yang first step kenapa, first thing kenapa kita kena ada business model, that kita nak diversity or variety in business model. Because over time, the most successful business model in industry akan predominate. Kan? Kadang-kadang bila kita buat business model sama, contoh katakanlah AirAsia tu, dia jual sama dengan MAS. Okay? Dulu kan, MAS jual tiket, kena beratur kat kaunter. Kalau AirAsia tak datang, dia tak providekan kita boleh jual beli online, maka kita masih lagi beratur dekat kaunter untuk beli tiket. So, sebab tu bila AirAsia datang, dia dah dominant. Dia dominant industri. Sebab benda tu dia dah makin cepat, makin murah dan sebagainya. Okay? Sebab tu, okay, antara salah satu untuk kita business model adalah to diversity of business model. Okay, how business model emerge? Melalui value change. The value chain is a string of activity that move a product from a raw material stage through manufacturing and distribution and ultimate to the end user. By studying a product or service value chain, an organization can identify ways to create additional value and assess whether it has the means to do so. Value chain as an analysis is also helpful in identifying opportunities for new business and in understanding how business model emerge. So, penting untuk kita kena pasti value chain so that kita boleh identify ways to create additional value. Lepas tu kita nak identify the opportunity for new business. This is the value chain. Okay, so dia ada primary and also support activities. Untuk primary, ada inbound logistik, ada operation, outbound logistik, marketing and sales and service. Support service, ada firm infrastructure, human resource management, technology development and also resource procurement. Okay, so entrepreneurs look at the value chain of a product or service to pinpoint where the value chain can be made more effective or to spot where additional value can be added. There are few types of value chain. Dan normally, macam cakap tadi lah, ada dua kan, single primary and also support. Okay, this type of analysis may focus on single primary activities such as marketing and sale. The interface between one stage of the value chain and another, such as interface between operation and outgoing logistic. Bila ada ni, single primary ni. Okay, kita kena tengok. Kita kena tengok value chain tu atas ikut you punya product or service. Jadi kita kena tengok kalau you ada produk A, kadang-kadang you tak perlu pun katakanlah you ada produk apa? Produk apa yang tidak memerlukan. Contohlah you ada you produk you tu brand, contoh macam Ramah-Ramah Founder kan. Dia ada produk tapi dia tak perlu kilang. Maksudnya dia tak perlu operation. Dia tak perlu ada logistik pada pembuatan barang. Jadi dia terus pergi ke marketing dan juga outgoing logistik sahaja. Okay. Jadi kat situ you kena tengoklah yang mana sesuai untuk you. Sebab dan bila katakanlah dia hanya sales and marketing sahaja, maka value untuk company dia hanya pergi sales and marketing lah. Sebab tu you boleh tengok macam Ali Syukri, Datuk Wida kan. Diorang more on marketing and sales. Jadi kalau you tengok dekat tadi value chain tadi ada sales and marketing. Ingat tak? Okay. Jadi dia tak perlu nak sibuk-sibuk dekat ingoing logistik tu. Okay. And pada support activities tu mungkin support activities tu kan ada 4 tadi kan. Pilih juga yang mana yang berkaitan. Ada yang orang guna semua, ada yang guna satu sahaja. Normally yang paling orang guna human resource lah. Sebab kalau you whatever industry yang you masuk, human resource tu adalah something yang sangat penting. Okay, potential fatal flaw in business. Ni biasalah bila you tak cukup baca you punya value chain tadi tu ataupun you tak faham dengan you punya business model, maka you akan menyebabkan customer tu akan kadang-kadang kita tak faham kan? Kita tak faham customer kita, kita tak faham business model kita. Jadi kita tak boleh nak match dua tu. Jadi itulah yang jadi kita pun tutup kedai. Itulah. Sebabnya kita unsound economic. Maksudnya kita jual rugi. Macam tu. Fatal flaw. Alright. Komponen dalam business model biasanya ada 4. Core strategy, strategic resources, partnership network and also customer interface. Core strategy ni yang ada dalam apa yang korang kena create adalah business mission you. Apa you product, apa you punya product and market scope. Apa you punya basis for differentiation. Maksudnya value lah. Value proposition yang korang nak. Yang tu adalah core strategy yang patut ada dalam you punya business model. Lepas tu baru you pergi ke strategic resources. Iaitu core competency, strategy asset kan. Asset yang ada. Partnership network. Yang ni yang you cari supplier, partners and other key relationship. Ni you boleh nampak jelas bila you buat BMC tu. Customer interface, macam you target customer, apa yang you buat untuk customer relationship, pricing structure. Okay, so this is the things yang you ni lah, saya dah terangkan tadi. Okay, mission statement. Saya nak terangkan pasal mission statement. Semua company, semua student company ni mesti ada mission statement. Mission statement ni adalah affirm mission or mission statement ni describe why you exist. Kenapa you buat kedai you ni? Kenapa you buat business you ni? Value proposition. What is business model is supposed to accomplish? Contoh you kata menjadi pembekal barangan sukan wanita yang tersohor dalam masa 2 tahun. Okay, 2 tahun akan datang. Contoh. You kena ada mission ataupun objektif yang terdekat you nak capai sebagai apa. Apa mission yang you nak accomplish. Okay. Product market scope ni biasalah apa market dan product you lah. Okay, yang you nak concentrate. Bukan semua orang. Contoh, kalau orang nak jual beg LV, dia tak boleh nak jual beg pasar malam. Tak boleh. Lain tu. Lain. Jadi, kena ada differentiation. Kalau orang jual MyV, dia tak boleh samakan dengan customer customer yang nak beli Mercedes. Dia lain. Kalau korang buat survey pun memang lain. Okay. Sebab dia punya behavior of the customer tu lain. Kalau you nak letakkan diri you sebagai customer pun boleh. Untuk memahami the behavior of your customer kan. Contoh macam MyV. Okay, MyV mungkin orang yang nak cepat, nak parking senang kan, nak murah, nak apa lagi. Tapi kalau yang Mercedes tu, dia nak safety, dia nak apa security tu lah. Nak safety, dia nak elegance, dia nak selesa. Sebab bila you pakai kendaraan mewah tu, dia memang selesa. Dia akan, sebab dia dah ada ciri-ciri yang dia dah kaji kan. On ni. Okay. Differentiation tu kena identify lah ya. Okay. Strategic resources. Kena tengok firm core competency. Kalau you ada 5 orang yang pandai IT, so go for online business. Kalau you ada 5-5 orang tu, 5-5 tak tahu apa pasal IT, buatlah business fizikal. Itu contoh lah ya. Okay, primary element of strategic resources ada core competency and strategic asset. Okay, ni dah cerita ni core competency tu. Contohnya capability you untuk mencapai firm competitive advantage. Contohnya Sony Sony dia punya competency lain. Dia lebih kepada miniature. Kalau Sony dia suka benda kecil-kecil. Kalau Dell dia suka kepada supply chain management. Okay, strategi asset macam mana kita nak make sure kita punya asset tu rare and valuable. Contoh kita ada location yang bagus, equipment yang bagus, plant yang bagus, brand, ada pattern, ada customer data, ada highly qualified staff and also distinctive partnership. Okay, strategic resources ni ikut kita punya ability to use the strategic kita punya planning tu lah. Yang tadi kita dah ada competency dan strategic asset and how we can use it strategically, kita akan jadi punya strategic resources. Partnership network, macam supplier and also other key relationship. Okay. Partnership ni banyak lah Ada joint venture, ada network, ada consortium, ada strategic alliance, ada trade association. Okay. Then customer interface. Customer interface contoh you jual dekat online. Macam contoh Amazon.com tu kan. Dia jual buku over the internet. Kalau Barnes & Noble, dia jual traditional bookstore and online. Jadi you kena faham kat mana you punya channel. Customer interface ni lebih kepada channel lah. You target customer you, fulfillment and support and also pricing model. Customer interface, ada target market, okay, ada fulfillment and also support. Okay, pricing strategy, pricing structure ni depends kepada target market and pricing philosophy. Okay, the importance of business model, it is very useful for a new venture to look at itself in a holistic manner and understand that it must construct an effective business model to be successful. As a result, a firm must motivate its customer and its partner to play along. Okay, jadi memang perlu business attention because it is essential. A business model sangat perlu because it is essential for a new venture success. Okay, there are a few type of business model. Ini saya sudah terangkan hari itu. Contoh, ada manufacturer, distributor, retailer, franchisor. Which one you boleh pilih lah. Sama ada you menggunakan business model brick and mortar. Brick and mortar tu macam fizikal, kedai fizikal. Maksudnya you ada kedai fizikal lah. You ada apa orang panggil bata. E-commerce in online. Apply both brick and click. Maksudnya e-commerce ada, kedai fizikal pun ada. So kita panggil brick and click. Nickel and dime, produk contoh seperti Tesco. Freemium, contoh Mendeley, Grammarly yang yang kita subscribe tu kan. App yang kita subscribe tu, freemium. Subscription macam Astro. Aggregator macam OU or Uber. Online marketplace, contoh Amazon, Fashion Valley. Advertisement macam Facebook, YouTube. Data licensing macam Twitter, Google. Agency base, contoh company pemasaran lah. So, you boleh tengok mana-mana company. Affiliate marketing yang dapat commission, tambah follower, melalui tambah follower, agent dari dropship dan contoh sebagainya Dropshipping, agent secara percuma atau ada fee. Network marketing, secara MLM, contoh macam Tupperware. Business model crowdsourcing, macam dia present. Lepas tu dapat duit, so dia membuat bisnes menggunakan duit orang lain, crowdsourcing. Peer-to-peer catalyst, lebih kepada user meet, contoh internet-based economy. Blockchain, SaaS ni bayar apa yang diguna, maksudnya macam prepaid tu. High touch adalah interaksi antara manusia ataupun lebih services lah. Macam you pergi spa, you pergi macam contoh pergi kedai LV tu, ada orang ikut seorang-seorang. Dia tak adalah korang masuk pergi ambil barang sendiri lepas tu baru bayar, bukan itu hard, itu low touch you pergi ambil macam supermarket tu kan, ambil lepas tu pergi dekat counter, itu low touch. Auction base, contoh peminat barangan antik lah, bid untuk harga paling tinggi. Lepas tu reverse auction base, bidding, bid untuk harga paling rendah. Razor and blade, peniaga involved dengan harga barang tinggi dapat harga rendah. Contoh produk OEM. Okay, dia dapat harga, dia macam dia dapat harga kilang RM20, dia jual RM200. Razor and blade, reverse razor and blade jual produk harga mahal kepada harga yang lebih murah. On demand, ikut keperluan. Contoh macam sekarang ni kita nak solidarity Palestin. Jadi bolehlah jual barang-barang on demand on solidarity Palestin. Macam dulu COVID, so kita buat barang-barang on COVID. And also user community, contoh cafe, ada membership fee dan sebagainya. Alright, so proses involved in business model, perlukan passion, strong desire, aspiration, independent, never give up, present on emotion, trust and dare to challenge self. Okay, so dia ada internal environment and external environment yang akan terlibat dalam business model innovation. Contoh, structure, organisasi dalam, sama ada dia organisasi satu-satu company tu, apa tu, dia menyokong innovation dalam business model, management team, business partner, financial asset capability. Ada juga external environment seperti ekonomi, teknologi, policies, competition and also customer. Okay, ways to succeed in business model innovation, mesti ada proper plan, mesti ada implementation, jangan rancang saja, mesti implement the suitable strategies are based on the situation and goal created. Mesti generate profit. Okay, grab the opportunity and be alert to the environment surrounding you, such as policy, community and new technology. Generate profit and mesti grow and sustain. Have a vision of thriving and being competitive. Okay, ni yang contoh dari business model tadi kan. Maksudnya dia approach to sell UPC versus traditional manufacturer. Ni traditional manufacturer. Dia kena ada contoh Hewlett Packard, HP dengan IBM dulu. Okay, dia tengok okay demand ramai orang nak pakai komputer ni. Lepas tu dia pun beli komponen, buat basic komponen, assemble complete PC. Lepas tu kena letak dah lama-lama dekat warehouse. Lepas tu barulah ada orang order, baru ship. Lepas tu yang lepas ship tu hantar dekat retailer tak. Ship kepada retailer, bukan ship kepada direct customer tau. Macam you nak pergi retail, you kena pergi dekat kedai dulu. Jadi lama lagi dekat kedai tu duduk, barulah ada consumer yang beli. Tapi Dell model, dia terus place order via phone dengan internet. Dia ambil order online. So siapa yang order, kalau manufacturer, dia akan ada contract manufacturing. So instantly dapat je order, dia bagi tahu kilang, kilang akan directly assemble the computer. Lepas tu dia akan dia akan ship the ni lah, the ni ship direct to the customer. Pasti in hands of consumer. Jadi dia tak pergi ke warehouse. Dia tak pergi ke. Okay, so next is a business model canvas. So actually what is business model canvas? So business model canvas is a strategic management template for developing new or documenting and upgrading existing business model. It is a visual chart with element describing a firm value proposition, infrastructure, customer and finance. It has at least 9 building blocks. Jadi, business model canvas ni adalah satu template, sekeping template sahaja, which is dia akan memberikan, dia mendokumentkan. Dan kita boleh tengok bila masa kita nak guna business model canvas ni, bila kita nak memulakan bisnes dan juga kita nak upgrade the existing business model. Okay, so dia ada 9 blok. 9 blok. Okay, why business canvas? Business model canvas ni kita gunakan to understand the external influences that affect the decision making process of social investor who will be using funds to shape their marketplace. Biasanya orang yang nak tengok nak funding ke kita punya ni, ataupun orang yang nak menilai business model kita tu memerlukan business model canvas ni adalah cara yang terbaik untuk kita present. So and then kita nak compel, sebab kita nak to tell the people in a very good story lah kan. Jadi nak try to compelling story about the impact of a market it operates in, their financial performance and their implementation plan. Business model, Canvas ni also able to design a business model for a company. Okay, how does it look like? Okay, this is the 9 blocks that I was mentioned in, earlier. Okay, we start is with value proposition. Okay, tengah-tengah ni value proposition. And then this is the customer segment and customer relationship and channel and revenue stream. Okay, this side semua cerita pasal customer. Okay, bagaimana kita nak menyampaikan value ataupun kita kata kita punya differentiation yang kita nak bagi dekat mereka, value position and all about the customer. Sebelah kiri ni pula adalah semua pasal company, activity yang buat, resources yang kita ada, partner-partner yang terlibat dan juga bagaimana kita nak mengendalikan company tersebut, iaitu cost structure yang kita perlu bayar. Okay. How to use BMC? Okay, business model canvas dekat tengah-tengah ni adalah value proposition. So, value proposition is the reason why customer turn to company over another. So, it solve a customer problem or satisfy a problem need. Maksudnya, apa yang kita nak sampaikan, apa yang kita nak selesaikan masalah customer, macam mana nak selesaikan, itu adalah value proposition. And then kita terus pergi ke customer segment. In order to better satisfy customer, a company may group them into distinct segment with common needs, common behavior and diorang punya attributes. Jadi kita kena betul-betul fokus kepada customer yang kita nak tu. Jangan macam kepada wanita sahaja, tidak. Dia wanita umur berapa, tinggal di mana, kat mana, apa behavior dia. Jadi kita kena fokus. So that barulah kita boleh mengendalikan kita punya operation of the company. Okay. And then customer relationship is a company should clarify the type of relationship you want to establish with each customer segment. Normally, customer relationship apa yang kita buat so that customer tu akan lebih suka untuk membeli tempat kita daripada customer menjadi regular customer, menjadi agent dan sebagainya. Okay. Channel ni adalah macam mana communication, distribution and sales channel comprise a company interface with customer. Bagaimana information dan juga produk kita, produk atau service kita ini sampai kepada customer. Macam information, you boleh guna online, offline dan sebagainya. Especially online lah kan. Boleh guna macam-macam. Macam Facebook, social media dan sebagainya. Tapi barang tu tak sampai dengan social media kan. Jadi kena guna juga lori dan sebagainya. Jadi what are the channel yang kita gunakan. Bagaimana barang itu atau information itu sampai kepada customer kita. And revenue stream adalah the cash a company generate from each customer segment. Daripada customer segment yang kita kena pasti tu, macam mana duit mereka ni sampai kepada company kita. Maksud duit company adalah revenue stream. Okay, we move to the next tempat iaitu sebelah kiri, iaitu start dengan key activity. Key activity ni apa activity yang kita buat dalam company tu. The most important activities a company must do to make sure its business model work. Contoh kalau you penghilangan, you mesti adalah activity kilang, mesti ada manufacturing, ada apa tu? Ialah kalau you nak buat makanan, kena masak dan sebagainya. Kena tulis everything. Key resources is the most important asset required to make a business model work. Contoh, activity apa tadi? Kalau activity you sales and marketing. So, dekat resources tu mesti ada HR, human resource yang berkait dengan marketing team. Contoh, kalau ada penghilangan, so mesti ada kilang dan sebagainya. Kena ada sumber yang mencukupi. Key partners adalah the network of supplier and partners that make the business model work. Contoh supplier kita, agensi-agensi yang terlibat, yang support kita. Cost structure is the most important cost incurred while operating under a particular business model. Creating and delivering value, maintaining customer relationship and also generating revenue all incur cost. Jadi semua benda yang kita nak dapatkan daripada hasil tu biasanya kita kena keluarkan dulu investment ataupun cost tu. Jadi berapa banyak cost yang kita yang perlu bayar itu perlu ditulis di dalam bahagian cost structure. Okay, so this is the description dia lah, customer segment, which customer and user are you serving. Contoh you nak guna mass market ke, niche market ke, segmented ke, diversified ke. Mass market ni dia tak ada difference between segment. Maksudnya kalau you jual makanan, jual makanan kepada semua orang. Kalau niche market tu dia small specialized market. Contoh LV, apa siapa sahaja pengguna dia kan, tiba semua orang pengguna dia. Okay, segmented pun ada different segment, kita choose. Diversified, kita two segment with totally different need and problem. Okay, kita contoh macam untuk jual barangan sukan untuk student sekolah dan juga untuk orang ramai. Maka, you boleh diversifikan dia punya customer segment. So, people based on the same segment would have similar needs and can be accessed through similar channel. Dengan kata lain, customer segment ni ialah who to sell to. Nak jual kat siapa ni? Okay, value proposition is a what is the unique about your service to the customer? What is the reason the customer chooses you? Does your value proposition satisfying customer need or solve their problem? Example, adakah kamu mengeluarkan sesuatu yang baru, newness? Ataupun you memang buat satu yang apa ni meningkatkan performance, customization product, design, brand, price, cost reduction, risk reduction, accessibility and convenience. Okay, ataupun value proposition ni adalah why you sell. Kenapa you jual benda tu? Okay, channel ni how to customer segment will be reached or connected. Atau dengan lebih kata lain, how to reach the customer. How will you distribute the product or service that you offer? Contoh, you nak guna yang mana? Which channel are effective? Which channel are efficient? Contoh, you nak guna direct selling ke online service ke, outlet ke, franchise ke, retail ke, strategic alliance ke, agent ke, etc. So, bila you nak cari channel ni, ada 5 perkara yang you kena faham in terms of the preparation. Okay, awareness dulu. Macam mana you nak create awareness? Mungkin you boleh guna Facebook dan sebagainya kan? Boleh guna social media. Evaluation, mungkin orang bagi feedback kepada produk you. Purchase, macam mana orang nak purchase? Mungkin dia pergi ke outlet ke, ada agent ke, ada direct selling ke, ya. Delivery, sama ada kalau nak COD, okay, macam mana nak delivery. Okay, kalau post, macam mana nak delivery. And also after sale punya services. Contoh kata kalau dia complain ke apa yang you dapat, ataupun you ada macam selepas diorang punya sale tu, you akan telefon diorang untuk dapatkan feedback dan sebagainya. Okay. Next is customer relationship. How you establish the relationship with the customer. What relationship that the target customer expect you to establish. What kind of step have you taken to establish and maintain with your customer. Example, you ada personal assistant ke. Macam bila orang masuk tu, ada orang yang ikut kan, layan you. Tu personal assistant. Ataupun self-service, automated services, communities, co-creation and etc. Ya. Okay, seterusnya is a revenue stream. Where and how much will you earn? What value do your customer want to pay? How they want to pay? What kind of activities and service that you offer that generate income for your company? For example, sales of goods, user fee, renting, licensing, consultation fee, and etc. Okay, and then key resources. What you need to sell? What kind of resources do you need to generate your business? Asset can be owned, leased or obtained by making use of the key partner. Example, sumber apa yang you perlu ada? Human resource, facilities, building, technology, machine, partnership, financial and etc. Key activities ialah what is your key activity that has to be carried out in order to make your business model work. What to do to reach your mission lah. Okay, which activity do you need to perform well in generating revenue? For example, you kena buat production ke, you kena buat design, you kena buat innovation, you kena buat networking, you kena buat sales and marketing, you kena buat promotion, service and also cost reduction. Okay, key partner, who is your key partner and supplier with whom are you appointed to boost your company? Contoh, who do you work with? They can be strategic alliance between non-competitor, joint venture from different industry, buyer-supplier relationship or strategic partners between competitor. Example is upper staff management, government agency, university institution and others. And key partner, ni you kena highlight juga ada beberapa perkara iaitu key partners motivation. Contoh macam mana kita nak reduce the risk and uncertainty, optimization and also economy of scale. And acquisition of particular and resources and activities. This is the motivation for involving the key partners. Okay. Cost structure is what is the most important cost to generate your business. list the cost based on your activities, iaitu ataupun orang kata how much does it cost. Example cost structure adalah worker salary, marketing fees, maintenance fees, traveling cost and also rental cost and etc. Okay, this is an example of a BMC. This is an example of lemonade. You tengok ni, you jual lemonade sahaja. So, cold tasty natural lemonade on the go. Dia jual dekat park visitors. Okay, you boleh guna online ni lah. Dia guna online, boleh booking dekat booth dan juga boleh dapatkan daripada online ni. Okay, Skype ni, Skype, business Skype yang free service eh. Tak ada produk, service. So, dia guna free internet and video calling. Cheap calls to phone. So, bila guna Skype tu murah lah daripada banding kita guna telefon biasa. Okay, dia guna dekat web user globally. Okay, so selain daripada dia jual prepaid and subscription, dia juga jual hardware, ya. Yeah? Okay, yang ni Gillette. Gillette ni produk dia kan. Gillette tu selain daripada dia jual Gillette punya pisau tu, dia juga jual handle tu. Handle, razor handle tu. Okay, jadi ada beberapa benda yang dia boleh jual selain daripada tu. Daripada apa, dia punya pisau. Okay. KFC, dia ada secret recipe. Dia punya value proposition adalah secret recipe. So, bila secret recipe, dia punya revenue stream, you boleh tengok franchising. Okay, dia boleh guna kaedah franchising. Okay, so ada 5 lah, ada 9 kotak kat sini. You all boleh gunakan this kotak untuk hantar assignment you all. Okay, that's all for today. Thank you.